Hey guys, what's going on? It's Crystal Collects, and in this video, I'll be revisiting the Japanese set Sky Legend. So there's still one card that I'm after, and it's the alternate artwork of the Legendary Birds, the one that looks like the stained glass. You may have seen this from the Hidden Fates ETB, but it is pullable from this set. So if you guys are unfamiliar with Sky Legend, it is part of Unified Minds in English, along with Miracle Twin and also GGN. For more information on this set, it has a total of 69 cards in the set, including the secret rares, and it originally came out on April 26, 2019. Each Japanese booster box of Sky Legend should guarantee at least one secret rare. So let's see what we get. Before we get started, please make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe for more multi-language Pokemon, Beyblade, and Mazeka Party content. Let's get started. All right, so we're now officially revisiting Sky Legend. We have my three favorite birds, not the Galar ones, the Kanto ones. Before we get into the opening though, let me just go ahead and cut the plastic off because there's a lot of glare. You guys are not going to be able to see anything. Alrighty, so we have our triplet, our trio, our birds. This is actually set SM10B, just so you guys recall, and lovely box specs as well. We've opened this before, but again, I have high expectations for this video because there's that one card I really want. But if we get any other birds, that's totally fine too. Lovely packs as well. And if you guys haven't also noticed before I get started opening the packs, we have a new guest for my video. We have the new Pokemon Yurito sleeves featuring Pichu, Pikachu, and Raichu. Why did I pick these sleeves? Because there's three of them, just like the three legendary birds. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get started cutting with the packs. 5 cards per pack, 30 packs per box. Let's see what secret rare we get, but also other cards as well. One thing I like about this set is how it features like special artworks of the legendary birds on specific cards, as I always mentioned before. I like how sets kind of, you know, play games with us like that. All right, we have a
Normalia. I also like to play a game. It's called Team Left and Team Right.
Oh yeah, Jay loves to remind me with this one. All right,
that's also a game I like to play.
So what is it today?
You already know.
Yep, Team Left.
I don't need to say anymore.
Jay is always Team Left.
I don't need to say it anymore, you know what I mean?
Right. And I am always Team Right because I always like being the exception. We have Mesprit, we have Steenie, very nice. Oh, we have Gladion. Actually, I don't think I pulled this yet, so I'm very happy I got another box. Very nice holographic with Sil Valley as well. I like how it's like in the shade. Really cool. Really like sleek. But yes, I'm always Team Right. Jay is always Team Left, but a lot of the time, as you would expect, Jay always wins.
Because not really. Sometimes you win too.
Sometimes. What I say, more often than not, Jay does win. I have Cryogonal. We have Koffing. We have Tapu Fini. Ooh, and lots of water type Pokemon in this set, which is very nice. Love this artwork by Mitsuhiro Arita. He did make a lot of the tag team artworks with the packs and also the box. Of course, the pack and box is going to be the same. But he's very, very well renowned. If you guys haven't heard of him, he did make the original Charizard artwork. But of course, a lot of other cards as well. We have here another trainer holographic. We have Jesse and James, who's also a full art in this set, along with Pokemaniac.
Roy and Rosa.
Yeah, Roy and Rosa in, I believe, Spanish, which is really cool.
You remember the Korean name?
Or is it the Korean name?
Yeah,
oh my gosh.
Oh,
it's the Korean name. I'm mixing up Spanish and Korean. I don't know why. When you translate the Korean Hangul for Jesse and James, it's Roy and Rosa, which I think kind of fits better considering they have like the letter R on their shirt, and we have recycling
team
energy.
Rocket.
Team Rocket, exactly, which is what the R stands for. But I think a lot of us grew up with Jesse and James and are way too attached to them, so we're going to stick with that, Jesse and James. But I like James's rose, which is blue. But I also like the full art. Of course, you guys probably saw that in Hidden Fates. Yes, a lot of these cards are in Hidden Fates, like the Ghastly, not the Ghastly, the Weezing, the Cough. Oh! Look who it is, and
that
look who wants
weird.
It. That's interesting.
We were just talking about
both the holo and the full art.
Wow.
That is amazing. So this is number 62 out of 54. Hit the like button, guys. I actually like this in Japanese because it has the nice Japanese texturing. Wow, Jesse and James.
That was so weird.
And here's the Japanese backing. Very nice though. I love how Meowth is just knocked out in the back there.
Yes.
But there we go. Yes, in Japanese. So we have Jesse and James. Full art on Team Right side. There we go. I won today because it's my birds. Okay, so not my trace card, but actually if I didn't get the birds, I'm very happy with that too because I love Jesse and James and I like the Japanese cardstock. I believe that's probably going to be harder to pull compared to the English one in Hidden Fates because I can't tell you how many times I pulled that card from Hidden Fates back in the day when I used to open English cards all the time. So
No more.
I don't know, guys. Like after opening so many cards in other languages and seeing the difference in the card quality, I'm too in love with the Japanese cardstock to go back to English cards. And we have Hoot Hoot with Zapdos in the background. I like that. Oh, we have Ekans with Articuno in the back. And we have a Sil Valley holographic along with Gladion. This is a very like trainer matching box. Not too much emphasis on the birds, but definitely emphasizing the trainers in the set. That's actually pretty cool. Big fan of that. All right. Oh, And we have one more card featuring another legendary bird you guys will see shortly. We have the U-turn board thing. Oh, there's Dwebble with Moltres, so that's the third one. I love those cards when it features all the legendary birds. Hopefully they do that with the Galarian legendary birds. Over time, they've really grown on me so much if you guys haven't seen my obsession with them on Instagram. I love the alternate artworks for them from Matchless Fighters, and I'm sure they'll look really awesome in Chilling Rain in English and the European languages, as well as the South American languages. All right, we have Cryogonal, we have a nice Magneton here, we have Mesprit, and then lots of holos in the set. We have Victini, very nice. Love the vibrance on that one. Oh, and it also starts with a V, look at that. Sorry, Team Left, I think we're taking a lot of wins today. Although, Team Red, yes, we have the secret rare, but we haven't yet pulled a GX, which is very interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe we'll pull one on Team Left side. The only way Jay can come back in this video is if we also pull a secret rare on that side. And here is Pokemaniac.
You never know.
Yeah, sometimes these boxes, they're a little crafty. You know what I mean? Sometimes they pop up with two and you're like, what? I didn't know there were going to be two in this box. But that's the best feeling. I like that because, you know, it catches you off guard and then you're very thankful that you opened all the packs from that box. We have Typhnoll, we have Snorunt, and we have Uxie holographic. Very nice, very lovely Sun and Moon holo foil pattern. The one from Sword and Shield is the vertical holo pattern. I think in black and white with this one, they had the horizontal holo pattern. All right, we're almost done with the first pile, so let's keep going here. But very shockingly early, that secret rare pull on the right side. I always notice it's like towards the front of the pile, and we have Normalium. There's a lot of text on that card. The Z crystals from back then. Oh my goodness, it's been a while. All right, but yeah, I can't honestly never get tired of this set. There's so many Sun and Moon sets I'm in love with, and this is definitely one of them. Again, unified minds. All the birds are unified mentally. We have Poipole, we have Lurantis, we have Snover, and we have Tapu Fini. Snover as opposed to Snorunt. This is the set that always gets me confused because it has both of them, and they both start with Snow. Snover, Snorunt. Once you play the games enough, that's how you remember the difference and also get to know them too. We have Licky Licky, Licky Squared. We have Noctowl Ekans with Articuno, Bounsweet, which was also an Indonesian promo, KFC promo. And there's our first GX. We have Naganadol. At least we have one for one side. With also my lovely Yuta Toe sleeves, you guys get a little closer look at them. There's also plushies to these, which is really adorable, by Mr. Kanahe, one of my favorite Pokemon artists. Of course, from Japan. He makes such cute artwork of like all different Pokemon, not just the Pikachu clan. All right, Team Left, here we go. Let's see what else we can get. I think we usually get like three or four GXs. I'm thinking Korean boxes. Yeah, 3 to 4 GXs. We have a lovely Frostlass holographic, but I mean, we pulled the secret rare. So, I mean, I'm not gonna expect too much from this left side. The chances of pulling two secret rares from one booster box, not the highest. Right, Jay? I don't think we've seen too many of those.
Not common, no.
Oh, we have us. We have Arbok with Jesse there. We have Dwebble. I almost forgot Jesse's name because of the different languages. And
what,
then we have Flamineum.
That
too, exactly. Yeah, Jesse was in the background though for the Arbok card, which is really cool. It threw me off a little bit. And I believe James is also on the Weezing card, so that's really nice. I like when the trainers are featured on their respective Pokemon. Okay, we have Magnemite, we have Numel, we have Snorunt, and then Magnezoon holographic. Very nice. Again, with the Japanese booster boxes, you're going to get a little pattern of packs with no pulls and then packs with something, maybe like a holo GX card, etc., at least for the Sun and Moon era. All right, let's keep going here. We have Typhnoll, Druddigon, Steenee, lovely artwork, and also Camerupt. You see what I mean by that pattern? It's very nice though, it's very consistent. So when you open those like special boxes that sometimes Japan releases, you also see a similar trend, even the Korean ones too. All right, one to the front here. Still got a bunch of packs left. We only got one GX so far though, but very nice secret rare, very happy. If I had to choose one of the two secret rares, oh, there are the birds. There we go, Team Left won this one with the birds at least. We have 35 out of 54, so not the secret rare. It's also not textured, so, but it's okay. Team Right still won today with the secret rare. But let's see who gets more GXs. I guess that's another game we could play. He gets the most GXs. I think Jay's probably gonna win this one, but it's okay. I love this set so much, and I'm glad at least we got one type of bird card. There's also the Hyper Rare GX Seeker Rare, and then the Full Art Seeker Rare, and then the Alternate Art Stained Glass. There's a lot of birds in this set. All right, we have the Recycling Energy. It looks like we have, I think, 8 packs left, so let's keep going here. The GXs definitely do not come up as often compared to Sword and Shield era. It always shocks me how little the pulls are, but you get a lot more holos, which is very nice, and a lot of nice holos as well. We have Lickitung, another Roy and Rosa, or James and Jesse. Oh, I did that backwards, interesting. Jesse and James. But yeah, the full art is very nice, and it's a lot glossier. Of course, the texture is a bit less on the Japanese cards compared to the English cards, but I do prefer that. I like the shinier glossiness. We have Flyminium, a lot of flying crystals because we got the flying burbs. All right, we got Type No, and we got Arbok with Jesse in the back commanding it, just like in the anime. All right, let's keep going here. Almost done. Handful of packs. Again, not that many GXs so far, just two plus one secret rare, which is very nice. Zerkatree looking very intense there. Bounsweet, Snover, Mesper. Ah, nice. We got Rowlet and Exeggutor, the neck Pokemon. Alolan Exeggutor. Very nice. He calls it neck Pokemon. It is what it is. But Rowlet, that's like the fiercest you'll ever see Rowlet on a card. Otherwise, it's just insanely cute.
Neck Pokemon. Because it's Rowlet. Cool.
Neck Pokemon is amazing.
Neck Pokemon.
We'll just stick with neck Pokemon. I think Exeggutor is a little bit long. Exeggutor is a little longer. We have James in the background. Amazing. Alright, continue. Yep, I'm good. You're just making me laugh. We have a Hoodoo and Zapdos. Oh, we have a Netball holographic. Very nice. It's not a net Pokemon. I don't think those are gonna come up very often. Alright, let's keep going here. Few more packs left and then we'll do our final review. Alright, one to the front here. We have another Normalium Crystal, very nice. Fomantis by Yukamori. We have Snover, Ekans with Articuno, and Audino. Oh my gosh, it's been a while, Audino. I remember seeing lots of Audino in Crown Tundra, and I'm like, wow, it's been a while since I've seen you finding this Pokemon. It's really cute though. Really good on HP, I believe. Okay, we have here Abomasnow looking scaly. We have Komia Noctowl, very nice artwork. Lurantis, Fletchinder, and holographic Serena. Lots of Serena and Sun and Moon. And we have three more picks. You have three more chances to see if Team Left can win this time. So I chose Team Left. I don't know if it's your video this time, but it's okay. Jay's giving me a funny face right now. It's okay, let's keep going. I mean, watch me talk all this stuff and then I get hit with a secret rare. And then Jay's gonna laugh at me because he got more GXs than me at this point. You got all the tag team GXs on this side, if anything. I just got a Naganadil, just an Ultra Beast. Okay, we got Tapu Fini, we got Cryogonal, Druddigon, we got Koffing, and another Silvally. So you'll have some repeats. Again, the set is only 54 cards in the main set. It's pretty small. 69 cards in total with the secret rares. All right, last pack. Will we get some last pack magic? I don't know, because we just got a holo. You guys know that pattern I'm talking about. Pull and then no pull. All right, we got a Dead City, we got Steenee, we got Numel, we got Fletchling, and Licky. All right, I'll be right back with you guys. Alrighty, so time for our final review. Of course, I will include all the holos. We got lots of Jesse and James's because there's a lot of nice artwork in the set, and I want to make sure I give you guys the full experience of Sky Legend. Japanese called Sky Legenda. Same thing, just pronounced in the Japanese language. And also there's going to be some repeats because again the set isn't that big. Again, only 54 cards in the set. We have Silvally and we have Gladion, which is very nice with Silvally in the background. I like that a lot. Okay, so here are GX cards. We have Naganadil, got a couple of tag team GXs. We have the birds, which is really cool. We have Alolan Exeggutor and Rowlet, super cute. And then here's our secret rare, the lovely Jesse and James full art. I did not expect this, but if I had to pick again out of the two trainers, this is the one I really wanted. So we got a total of four pulls. And I guess I just have to keep looking for those birds. They're very elusive, but it is what it is. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to hit the like button and also subscribe for more multi-language Pokemon, Beyblade, and Mazinga Party content. Stay safe, everyone. We'll see you in the next video.